What's going on, guys? Matthew Sabia here. Now, if you guys don't already know, I'm the CEO of a company called Deepwork, a network of e-commerce brands, which collectively does around 8 figures in profit every single year. Now, some of those websites I own privately and others I take on investors, some people like yourself, to go 50-50 on those and build them with other people. Now, the reason these stores are so successful is not just because we have a really kick-ass team of media buyers that knows how to scale products on Facebook. They work with some of the top 50 brands in the world. One of the reasons is we get recurring customers and our customer comeback rate and retention is pretty off the charts. Now, that is mainly due to email marketing. Email marketing is one of the most underrated things that a lot of e-commerce entrepreneurs, both beginners and veterans, really miss out on, and they're leaving so much money on the table. So what I wanted to do in this video, obviously, is not cover absolutely everything, but show you the fundamentals of everything that you need, or at least 90% of it, to really 3X the sales on any e-commerce business. So if you're just starting out, please make sure you implement these tactics. It's completely free using Klaviyo, that's a tool that we use. Or if you're already generating sales in your e-commerce store, congratulations. You could easily go in and 3X your sales using these exact email flows. So I'm gonna go here on my computer and actually show you the exact templates, the flows, the timing that we use, the templates, how we format the emails, and everything that we do to collect those emails from customers to actually get these results. So without further ado, let's dive right into it. So first things first, I want to show you guys some of the results that one of these flows is getting for one of our partner stores. And again, if you want to learn more about that and actually partner with us on one of these brands, click the link down below in the description. There's more info there. I'm not going to go over too much in this video. But before we really jump into this, make sure you click the like button down below. Really helps out this channel. If you guys got some value out of this video, helps other people find it as well. And make sure you click on subscribe to know when I upload other videos just like this one, because we will be going way more in depth on email marketing very soon in the future. All right, guys. So before I show you the copy of the actual emails themselves, I want to hop in here in the back end of one of our partner stores inside of Klaviyo and show you the actual power of email marketing when it comes to e-commerce. You can see the crazy numbers here. Now, obviously, I'm gonna blur out the name of the actual website and other identifiable information, but you guys could see some of these live results right here inside of this Klaviyo account. This one email right here generated around $44,000. The ones down here respectively did $11,000 and $13,000. And this particular store was only running for a matter of like 4 to 5 months, I believe. And you guys can really see the power of email marketing, all the money you're gonna be leaving on the table if you don't implement the flows like I'm about to show you here. Okay, so now that you guys understand the power of email marketing when it comes to e-commerce, let's actually go in and start setting some of this stuff up. So again, we prefer to use Klaviyo for all of our email marketing, but if you have something a little bit different, that's fine too. The reason I like Klaviyo is because it's tailor fit for e-commerce businesses and it's free to start if you're just a beginner. So the first fundamental email flow we want to jump into is the abandoned cart reminder. Now, after that, I'm going to show you guys how to set up the initial coupon flow, which gets people into your email list, and the bounce back flow and a couple other things that we use as well. So if I go in here and let's first analyze one of our abandoned cart emails, and I can show you guys why it's so effective. So abandoned cart email is an email that goes out if a customer comes to your website, initiates a purchase, but doesn't actually check out. So what's gonna happen is this email is gonna send out to them within the hour, reminding them to come back to their cart, which is gonna be saved. You could offer a discount or you could just do a reminder. Typically, the flow that I like to use is you initially start just reminding them to come back to the cart. You know, maybe they're checking out on their phone, but they don't have their credit card on hand. They wanna do it on their computer. Happens quite often. Just because someone leaves and abandons their cart doesn't mean they're not interested. So the first email, as you can see here, it's simply gonna be a little bit of a reminder, simple call to action, this beautiful image that's related to the brand, and then a call to action, remind them to go back to their cart page. Now, the follow-ups after that are gonna be very, very similar to this, except you're gonna offer progressive discounts. Let's say you're already not offering free shipping, offer free shipping in the next email, keep it similar to this one. A day after that, offer them maybe like a 20% discount on the items in their cart. Typically, we don't like to push it a little bit further than that, because if someone doesn't buy after 3 reminders, they're probably not interested and you're gonna have to circle back around and get them again the next time. Now, the next fundamental email you need to set up for your e-commerce business is what we like to call a bounce back email. Now, a bounce back email is essentially an email that goes out that's encouraging a second purchase immediately after the first one. Now, Let me break down the logic on exactly why this works and why it's so profitable. There is simply no warmer lead than someone who just bought something from your store. You know, there's no more qualified that they can get than someone who actually just gave you money for an item. So what we like to do for these emails, I have one on the screen right here, we'll break it down. So the headline up here, we just say hurry, add any of the items below and get an instant 15% off. Then we had the little clock icon. There's some tools that actually let you put dynamic timers inside of your emails. We played around with those, but sometimes just the clock right there really creates that urgency, that's fine. You could also go in there, like I have in the bottom right here in the highlighted text, order within the next 15 minutes and then just use the code, and then you could have dynamic coupon codes generated inside of Klaviyo. So you could actually have Klaviyo generate a new coupon for each individual person, and then you're not gonna have like one that they could use over and over again. So once they use it, it's just for that person, then it expires and it's gone. Then below that, we simply have the best selling products for this store. Now here's the thing, you could do that, or sometimes what I like to do for other brands is we have our email team set it up so that it's one specific collection. So for example, let's say you were doing like a clothing store. Someone comes, they buy a hat or a pair of socks. Then you send a bounce back email that says, hey, all t-shirts are 20% off only for the next 15 minutes. Grab them now. They're already in a buying mood. They already approved. They are already like a really warm lead, like I said. So these emails convert pretty well. If I actually jump over here, you can see what one of these bounce back emails actually generated over the last 30 days for one of these brands. Okay, so last but definitely not least, this is the most important email flow that you need to have, because this is where you're gonna get customers into your email list on your e-commerce store. This is the first email flow they're ever gonna go through. And that is the initial coupon flow, we like to call it. Pretty self-explanatory. You're gonna design a pop-up that shows up on the website. You can also embed it on the website, have like slide-ins they're called, or whatever other way that you find effective to get people onto your website. These are the emails you want to use. So you need to offer some type of offer, some type of coupon in exchange for their email. So, you know, enter their email in exchange for 10% off, maybe 20% off, plus free shipping. I know this is pretty self-explanatory, but the bigger and better the offer, the more likely they are to opt in. So if you could squeeze in a bigger discount in exchange for that lifetime value of having them on your email list, make sure you factor that in. So let's take a look at an example of some of our initial coupon emails. So here's a great example right here. We start off with this big headline. So here's your coupon code, sometimes an emoji related to the brand, that's fine. And then we have one of those Klaviyo dynamic coupon codes, which I can show you how to set up here in a minute. That's gonna show right there. We have a little helper text underneath, I like to call it. So just enter this code at checkout, receive 15% off plus free shipping. We have a brand related image down here just to grab people's attention when they first open the email, because you gotta remember, this is probably the first email they're ever gonna receive from your brand. So make this a good one. We have a little note from the founders of the company, or just something that's in the brand voice. Write some kind of personal note there. Thank them for coming and checking you guys out. Then we just end off with a very simple call to action that says, click here to shop. Now after that, you wanna remind them of that coupon code a couple of times. So have this one sent out immediately once they fill out their email. You don't want to keep them waiting, because maybe they're already ready to purchase something and they want to enter their email to get that discount. After that, if I go back here, you can see we typically have like a 1 day delay. Next day, remind them again, very similar email. Another day, third time, very similar email. And then typically what you wanna do is just have them on what we like to call the welcome flow. I know I'm not including that in the three fundamental ones here, but it is something that you should start crafting as well. The welcome flow is, again, pretty self-explanatory. It's the welcome flow to your business. Start sharing more brand information. If there's a story around your brand, which there should be, start sharing that. Maybe share videos, content that's gonna help the people out, no matter what you sell. Maybe you have a store that's underwater turkey hunting. Give them a free underwater turkey hunting book. What you're doing is psychologically training people to want to open your emails, because they're going to associate them with value, okay? So make sure you have them go on a welcome flow after that, and don't make that one too urgent. What I mean is, don't make it too frequent, I should say. Only have that one go out every 2 to 3 days. Though, speaking of that though, I want to throw this one thing out there. One thing a lot of people are worried about is, oh, I don't want to burn out my subscribers. Well, here's the thing. It's kind of the same philosophy in the film industry, where people say, oh, you know, no one's gonna sit through a 3 or 4 hour movie. That's simply not true. By the way, the reason they do that is each movie theater only has certain time slots, and they actually won't show your film unless they could fit in so many. But what my point is no one ever complains about getting too much of something they like. Like, if people are really enjoying your emails and it's really adding value to their life in some way, they're not gonna say, guys, stop sending me these emails. It's too much great stuff. I don't want to receive these.
It's too much. Excuse me. It's too much.
So don't worry about that. There are some brands where, guys, we're sending out 2, sometimes 3 emails a day, and the customer retention on that list, or the unsubscribe rate, I should say, is pretty damn low. So don't worry about burning out your list, but you need to make sure you're offering good content inside of those emails, otherwise that is going to happen. Okay, so now that you have that in place, let's go back into my computer one more time, and I'm gonna show you how we set the basic default template that we found converts best. So guys, I'm gonna be giving you the basic email template. I know it's not rocket science, but this basic email template has generated over $10 million in sales across our network of e-commerce brands. So pay attention and model this exactly if you want to. Okay, so here is the default template that we use for every brand when we start creating our email flows. Now, one thing I want you guys to keep in mind is you want to bring your email readers onto your website as much as you can in the actual email. As you can see here, we have the logo at the top, and then we basically have a little menu bar at the bottom right here. Now, occasionally we'll actually put a little announcement bar above this as well. So like you see on a lot of e-commerce websites, you know, 10% off, use this code, free shipping this week only. You can put that up there as well, but basically transport them to the website and let the email do the selling before they even go to the website. So kind of the opposite of what you want to do with affiliate marketing. You guys have heard me talk about this before. So next we have this attention getting headline. You're going to customize this for every email, a placeholder image. Here you want to put something that's brand related, whether that's a product photo or a stock photo that's related to the brand, something to grab people's attention and just make the email a little bit more aesthetically pleasing and friendly. Under that, we have the body text, which should just be customized right here, and then the simple green call to action. Now, as much as you can, I do recommend leaving all your call to action buttons green. It is proven to convert a little bit better, but like you see in some of the examples before, sometimes the brand colors really do bring the whole thing together and the conversion rate doesn't really take a hit. So this is the basic template that you guys can go in, create this inside of Klaviyo, save it as a template, and then you could use this every time you go to create a new email. And that, guys, is essentially it. Now, yes, there's plenty more that goes into email marketing, and I'm probably gonna make a lot more videos about this, but my point is these are the fundamental email marketing tactics you need to implement tonight to start 3Xing your e-commerce sales. It's extremely important. If you are not doing any type of email marketing, guys, you are leaving so much money on the table, it's not even funny. Because every time that you go and you pay for a Facebook ad or wherever you're buying advertising, you get a customer into your business, you need to pay for that customer again to come back around. Instead, get the customer in one time, build a relationship, and give them actual offers and value through emails, and have them keep coming back over and over again. It's one of the most profitable tactics that you need to be implementing for your e-commerce business. So guys, again, my name is Matthew Sabia. If you want to partner with us on one of these websites, go down below. We're going to handle everything between choosing the product, building the website, running the Facebook ads. My media buying team has scaled some of the biggest brands in the United States. And yes, we'll be doing your email marketing as well. Link for that is down below. Click the like button at the same time while you're down there. It really helps out this channel. It's gonna help other e-commerce entrepreneurs like yourselves find this content. I know things are rough out there for some people, but in the e-commerce space, this is the best time to jump in. You have my word on that. Also, click the subscribe button. That's gonna notify you when I upload new videos. Click the little notification bell. And my name has been Matthew Sabia. I hope you guys enjoy this and got some value out of it. Can't wait to hear about your email marketing journey down below in the comments, and I will talk to you next time.